Hey, hey, everybody, this is Larry. This is me going with Q3 of the weekly contest 332, Substring XOR queries. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, join me on Discord. Let me know what you think about this problem. So this problem, there is a lot of reading for sure and understanding what it's asking for, right? So basically, first thing that I try to do is just think about what is it asking, right? And here you have basically, you're given this query. You're just basically getting a query in which a value XOR the first item, the first input, the first parameter, and then you get the second parameter. Of course, this is I don't. I mean, I guess it is what it is. It's a small thing, but it's still a thing, I suppose. And basically, given this here, the thing is that, well, if you want to build, and you know, we know that. For the rest of this problem, we have queries and we want to answer a lot of them, right? So the way that we want to look for is looking for a value that does this. And of course, one very reasonable simplification is to move the first sub I to the right side. And in this case, if the inverse operation of first sub I is actually just another XOR. Let me say it again. The inverse operation of XOR is XOR. So you're okay with XORing first sub I on the other side. It's almost similar to the inverse. Is it inverse? Maybe it's, but in any case, I think it's the something identity. But inverse identity, maybe? I'm getting my math terms funky, so definitely leave in the comments if I'm saying something wrong. But for example, if it's value plus first sub I is your second sub I, you probably find it really easy to figure out that actually we just want to search by this minus this thing, right? So same idea, but with XOR. This you may or may not be familiar with, but you know, this is just one of those things that takes practice and seeing this enough times is what I mean by practice, to be honest. Okay, so then now we're looking for value, right? And what are we trying to do with this value? We're trying to find a substring in which the decimal value matches this, right? So from that, I think one thing to kind of keep in mind is that we can brute force a lot of things. And what do I mean by that, right? What I mean by that is noticing that if you have a string of 32 bits, right, that is, I mean, even less than that, to be honest, but let's just say 32 bits because that fits in an int. And because of that, if you look at the constraints for each of the query, first sub I and second sub I is 10 sub 9. So value is going to be that we're searching for is going to be within 10 sub 9 or 10 to the power of 9 or a billion, right? And a billion, if you can be represented by 30 bits. I just chose 32 just from, you know, I don't know, just Larry things. But the idea is that you can pre-calculate based on knowing that, right? Because basically the idea is that because the biggest length is 32, so an implicit constraint of this problem is that for the query, for the things that we're querying, the value is going to be less than 32 on the string, right? So basically now you're saying, okay, given the string, find a substring of 32 letters or 32 binary bits. And of course you can do this in a number of way, but it should start to be more simple, right? Because now instead of, you know, n square number of substrings, now you have 32 times the n, right? As the number of substring, we can maybe say log of r, where r is the range of the queries. But either way, it's going to be 32 times n. And 32 times n is going to be fast enough. This is only 10,000, so it's like 3,200, 320,000. Right, is basically what I'm trying to say. So basically, how do I pre-calculate this, right? Literally, just do, just calculate the value of all the strings in which there's one, the length is one, which is just 0 and 1, and then length is 2, which is 0, 1, you know, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, and so forth, right? And then you if you go from small to big, and maybe not care about, and you know, you could handle leading zeros in a different way, but if you go from small to big and left to right, then you will automatically satisfy the one with the minimum left sub I, and they don't actually tell you that right sub. Oh yeah, no, because there's leading zeros, so if they're shorter than left sub I, yeah, okay, yeah. So basically, that's the, like I said, that's basically the idea. You do it for L is equal to 1, and then 2, and then 3, and then 4, dot, 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 and that's pretty much it. So I'm going to go over my code next from that idea, right? So I have a lookup. I was going to use this, but then I end up just storing as a tuple. But lookup basically, lookup sub x is the first appearance of the binary bits x. With the length, right? And that's basically what I'm doing here. I start with from 1 to 32. I created a bit mask just so that I don't have to do the shift and subtract. You could do a shift and subtract, but the idea is still going to be a sliding window, right? Of, okay, and you could say it's a sliding window. Maybe you could also think of it as a shift and add, but same idea. You basically have a window of length L, and then you, when you go from left to right, you shift everything, and then you subtract stuff that falls off, and so forth. And I use this bit mask to keep that for that reason, because you can think about this bit mask as just, you know, 1 1 1s of the length of L, right? This has length L, so then now we just kind of do a bit mask N, and that's basically how I keep track of things. Yeah, so I start with 0, and this is going to be shift and add, like I said. Yeah. And you can actually maybe be a little bit more precise in making sure that I is greater than or equal to L or something like that. But it turns out that you don't have to, just because of the way leading zeros and stuff like this works. And that, yeah, because you're going from small to big, you don't need to. I didn't actually prove it. I think I just got a little bit lucky, to be honest, only during the contest. I mean, it's true, but I didn't think about this. It was just sloppy and I got lucky. But in any case, because I think you should have like I L minus 1 or something like this, just to be more precise. But like I said, you don't need it. But yeah, basically all this does is it keeps track of the starting point. If we haven't seen this current bit before, like the series of bits, but represented as a binary number or a decimal number with a binary representation, so then you do a lookup, and this is the starting index, and this is the length, as we, you know, as we know. And then after that, we just, you know, literally just use the lookup. We back calculate the starting index and the length, the starting index and the right based on the length. I guess you could have also just this would have been I, so I or I minus one, I forget, but so I actually maybe could have just done it that way. I don't know. They're all equivalent numbers. You just have to do maths a little bit funky. So yeah, if it's not found, then you return the negative one default values, and that's pretty much it. So what's the complexity, right? So the pre-calculation part is going to be O of n times log r, where r is the range. And for each query, it's just O of Q for the number of queries and plus one for each. The space is going to be also O of log R. O of N log R, because that's the number of, in theory, distinct things, though maybe in practice you can maybe have a tighter bound. But that's also the space, and plus Q as well, because that you need O of one thing for space. So in total, let me just write it down here. O of N log R time plus Q time, whoops, and then also space. Cool. Yeah, that's all I have for this one. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you think. And you could watch me solve it live during the contest now. About this one at all, to be honest. Okay, fine. Because so many off by one opportunities is why. I mean, it's not hard conceptually, just so many off by ones. Okay, focus. And knowing LeetCode, it might still be wrong later on, because the test cases don't mean anything anymore. Okay, focus queries, web queries. Okay, what does that mean? Shortest substring of S sub I such that whose decimal, who are you, use second sub I when bitwise the first sub I, meaning, okay, why? Return the minimum left sub I. Okay, so zero. Oh, the basic we're trying to find five. Okay. Okay, and then this two, and we can just see if we can do three. So this is three. And. Twelve and eight is what? So 32. Let's see, right? It's just brute force, I suppose, and then it is. Because there's 32 times, so okay, fine. Thirty two should be enough. Okay, fine. And then basically, and then we want a spy. L is 0, and L should be at least 1. And I guess you might as well make it 33. Should be okay either way. So then now if L is 1, then this is this plus 1 is the starting, right? Maybe. Man, I'm really bad at off by ones. So this is 0, and this is 1, then this is 1, it goes from 0. This is the last one, okay, fine. I guess I could just do it this way, actually. Maybe off by one, but okay. So three, 2 and 4. So this is off by one. Oh, because of the length, that's fine. If it times out, I'll be sad, but it should be okay otherwise. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, join me on Discord. Let me know what you think about this problem, the explanation, this contest maybe, and everything in between. That's all I have. So stay good, stay healthy, to good mental health. I'll see y'all later and take care. Bye-bye.